it is very common for every one of you that you are having a bank account. Also, you issue the check for paying your various dues like electricity bill, mobile bills, etc. Your banker, financier also take from you post-dated check, that is PDC, when you take loan, that is car loan, home loan or personal loan. Many times it happens that your check is dishonored or bounced due to the various reasons like insufficiency of funds in your bank account. The most common reason for dishonor of the check are lack of funds in your account from where check is issued, and that is the main and most common reason for the check to bounce if the check is overridden. Next one is the problem with the date of the check, that is either post-dated check or the check having the date which is more than 3 months old on the date of the presentation of a check, or if the date is not mentioned or written incorrectly. If the signature is absent, that is no signature on the check, or the signature in the check does not match with the specimen signature kept by the bank, that is signature mismatch. If the name of the payee is absent, that is not written on the check or not clearly written. If the amount written in the words and figures does not match with each other and differ. If the account number is not mentioned clearly or is altogether absent. If the person who issued the check orders the bank to stop payment on the check. If the code of law has given an instruction or order to the bank to stop payment on the check. Further, if the person who issued the check has closed the account before presentation of the check by the check recipient. Also, if the fund in the bank account are insufficient to meet the payment of the check. If the bank receives the information regarding the death or lunacy or insolvency of the person who issued the check. If any alteration made on the check is not proved by the person who issued the check by giving his or her signature, or it is a disfigured or damaged check, any of these issues in the check may result into dishonor thereof by the bank. In today's video, if you are an accused in the check bounce case, means that you have issued a check to somebody and that check has bounced, and the party to whom you have issued the check has filed a case in the court against you under section 138 of the Negotiable Instrument Act, and various defenses which you take before the court, whether they may be accepted by the court or not. Also, I shall be discussing with you the various remedies available to you when a check is issued by you has bounced. If those are applied to the facts of your case, then you may win that case, or that case may be rejected by the court of law. Keep watching this video till end in order to get the full benefit out of this video. My dear friends, firstly, I shall share with you the problems in dishonor of the check. When the check is dishonored, a check return memo is sent by the bank to whom check was issued, that is payee, stating reasons of the dishonor of the check. The payee can resubmit the check if he believes that it will be honored second time. The payee can prosecute or file a case in court against the person who issued the check, that is drawn legally, if the check is bounced again. The Negotiable Instrument Act is applicable for the cases related to the dishonor of the check. As per section 138 of this act, dishonor of check is a criminal offense and is punishable with monetary penalty or imprisonment up to 2 years or both. So far as penalty is concerned, if a check is bounced, then a penalty is levied on both the issuer of the check, that is drawer, and the receiver of the check, that is payee, by their respective bankers. The person will additionally have to pay late payment charges if dishonored check is against repayment of loan. So far as the damage to the credit history of yours is concerned, your credit history is negatively impacted if a check is dishonored, since your payment activities are reported to the credit bureaus by the financial institutions from whom you have taken the loan, either home loan or car loan or personal loan. the lender will trust you if you have a good credit score. In order to have a good credit score, it is a good practice that your check do not get bounced or dishonored. Your good payment activities will help you build your good CIBIL score and benefit you at the time when you approach your banker for a fresh loan. Keep the above points in mind while writing the check so that the check is not dishonored. Unfortunately, if a check issued by you got bounced, in that case, what remedies are available to you to defend your case in the court are shared here. I am going to share with you the most important things which you should try to find out in the facts of your check dishonor case so that you can win that case or the case against you for the dishonor of the check is dismissed by the court and you may save yourself from the various penal provisions of the Negotiable Instrument Act. Normally, it is seen that various parties against whom the case is filed in court for dishonor of the check, then they are taking very illogical and unrealistic defense before the court in their check bouncing case, which are not tenable in the court, and the court does not recognize them and do not grant any relief to the accused of the check dishonor. Some person take the defense before the court that they have only signed the check and other contents of the check are not filled up or written by them. This is a very big defense under the Negotiable Instrument Act. This will not save you in the court. Some persons take defense before the court when their check is bounced, that their checkbook was stolen or that their check was stolen. Then after they make a complaint at the police station or they file online complaint after the dishonor of the check. This is not going to help you out in the court because this is also very big defense in check bouncing case. This justification is treated as an afterthought by the court and therefore court does not give any benefit or relief for this. Some persons take the defense before the court that mere se kisi ne dara dhamka ke check le liya tha. That is, the check was taken by intimidating to the check issuer by the other party. In this case, the question will be asked, jab aapko dara dhamka ke check liya gaya tha kisi aur ne, to why did not you file a complaint before the police at that time immediately? That today, when check bounce, then you are complaining ki mere se dara dhamka ke check le liya tha. This defense will also not help you out in the check dishonor case in the court. Some accused of the check dishonor do not accept the legal notice when that come to their house or they change their house or residence so that they may not receive the legal notice. This is also not a defense under the Negotiable Instrument Act because as per the Indian Evidence Act, if the legal notice is sent to your last known address and you do not receive the legal notice, then that will be deemed to have been served upon you and received by you under the Indian Evidence Act. Court will presume that the legal notice has been served upon you and you are avoiding willfully to take that notice. Some other accused make certain other mistakes also. Like even if they accept the legal notice, even then they do not appear before the court on the appointed date fixed for hearing. They change their address, they change their residence, or they abscond also. Gayab ho jate hain. All these tactics will just weaken your case and will not help you out in check dishonor case. If you try to run away from the legal process, then the magistrate will issue the warrant against you and you will be arrested and your problems will increase manifold. Some accused close their bank account after issuing the check to other party or they issue the check from their closed bank account thinking that if they issue a check from their closed bank account then it will not come within the purview of the check dishonor case. This is your galatfahmi or a myth. If your check get bounced for whatever reason, whether you have stopped its payment or your account has been blocked by the banker, or you have closed your bank account, then you are liable for the check dishonor under the Negotiable Instrument Act. It is possible that you have signed differently on the check than the signature available with the bank, so that there is a signature mismatch. In that case, the court may send the check to the forensic lab and get it checked that whether it is your writing on the check or not. Please note that if your check is in the hands of other person, then the court will first ask you how your check reached in the hands of that other person. The presumption by the court is that the check has been given by you to other person against your legal and foreseeable loan or debt or liability, and you have already received the consideration against that check, and therefore you have issued this check or given the check to that other party. Because you will not give the check to somebody just for fun's sake, that is without any liability on you. This is the presumption under the Negotiable Instrument Act. Whatever defense just I have discussed with you, they are not going to help you out in your check bounce case under the Negotiable Instrument Act before a court. My dear friends, it is my sincere advice to one and all that do not take the various defenses which I just shared with you in a check dishonor case against you, because they are not going to help you out but going to increase your problems in check dishonor case. In my next video, I shall be discussing with you the various legal ways available to you in a check bounce case, so that you can use them successfully to win a check bounce case against you in the court of law. Stay safe and healthy. Bye-bye.